Hello everybody, today I'm going to explain how do you obtain a triangle wave by adding lots of sine waves. So what is a triangle wave? A triangular wave is a non-sinusoidal waveform named for its triangular shape. It is periodic, piecewise, linear, continuous function. Alright, in order to obtain a triangle wave, we need to perform additive synthesis using a bunch of sine waves. Before we do that, let's study the spectrograph of a 500 Hz triangle wave. So this is a spectrograph, and as you can observe here, the fundamental frequency is at 500 Hz, and it is indeed followed by odd harmonics, which is 1500, 2500, and so on. So the most important thing to note here is that the energy levels of the odd harmonics die down rapidly compared to the energy levels as observed in the square waves harmonics. So we're going to reverse engineer this. We're going to feed in the sine waves with their particular energy level so as to obtain the triangle wave. Alright, here's a Fourier expression for the additive synthesis. So this is the main equation, and on plugging in the value, the range from 0 to n, you end up getting this equation. So that's omega sine of omega t minus 1 by 9, sine of 3 omega t plus 1 25th, sine phi omega t, and so on. So here, if you can observe, this is 1/9 and 1/25, so this is nothing but the square of 3. So 9 is square of 3 and 25 is square of 5. So that is the amplitude, and the amplitude, as this, you know, as the series progresses, it goes, you know, it becomes smaller and smaller. I mean, clearly 1/25 is way smaller than 1/9, which is smaller than 1. So this is a clear indication how the amplitude of the odd harmonics are going down rapidly as for a triangle wave. And the other thing to note here is you'd be observing a minus and a plus symbol and then minus. That's because the odd harmonics are, you know, out of phase with respect to each other. So for example, the third harmonic is 180 degree, you know, offset with respect to the fifth harmonic. So that's the reason why you have the negative and the positive symbol. All right, now what we're going to do is we're going to take the first equation, and then we're going to, you know, add many more harmonics, and we're going to observe how the triangle wave is formed. All right, here's the first harmonic or a pure tone sine wave. The equation is sine omega t. I'm calling omega t as x. So it's a pure sine wave. You can observe the sinusoidal function. Now we're going to keep adding, you know, odd harmonics so as to convert this into a triangle wave. Alright, now we have added the third harmonic to the first harmonic, so as you can observe, the equation sine x minus 1 over 9 times sine 3x, so sine 3x is the third harmonic, and this is the first harmonic. Let's keep adding harmonics. Alright, so now we have added even the fifth harmonic in addition to the third harmonic, and as you can observe, the graph is gradually approaching a triangular pattern. Alright, now we have added all the harmonics up to the seventh, so that's third, fifth, and seventh. So as you can observe, we have almost achieved a triangular pattern, and we have reached convergence. That's because, like, you know, the harmonic terms, they're like decreasing in magnitude. So, like, you know, if you can observe here that the seventh harmonic has an amplitude of negative 1 by 49, that's like 0.02. So that's pretty low. So any harmonic after the seventh is not going to make a lot of difference to the pattern. So yeah, so we have achieved the convergence. Now let's just compare a real and an ideal triangular wave. Alright, here's a comparison of real and triangular waveform. So in this example, the one with the blue dot is a real triangular wave pattern, and the one in magenta is the ideal case. So when I said real, I have considered the additive synthesis up to the seventh harmonic, whereas ideal is the additive synthesis considering harmonics up to infinity. So let's study this graph. So we do observe that the real triangular waveform traces out the ideal one pretty accurately in most regions, maybe except at the pointy edges. It has a little bit of error, but still it does a great job tracing out the ideal one, and that's because of a reason. The reason is, like, the higher harmonics after 7th, the 9th, 11th, and so on, their amplitude is so low that they do not really contribute to the waveform. So it's as good as, like, not having those harmonics at all, and you still end up having the same waveform and even the same sound. Now, in case of triangular waves, you know, since they're, like, more rich in the fundamental and their harmonics die down so rapidly, they sound almost close to a sine wave, maybe a little bit off, but they do sound real close to, like, a pure tone. They don't have like, you know, brilliance in sound. And they do sound dull. They are not bright like a sawtooth wave or a square wave. Alright, thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions, or hit the comments, I'll be sure to respond. Thank you. Have a great day.